Hello friends, in my career I've grappled with the following questions. How can my research make a difference outside of academia in the real world? How can my research result in positive outcomes that help people in society lead better lives? To show you how I've attempted to address these questions, I'm going to briefly introduce you to these two areas. One, how I've used 360-degree immersive videos to introduce research findings to social work practitioners and students. Two, to show you some of the positive impacts that these have had on learners. In future videos, I'll show you the philosophy behind the learning designs, the theory, and the practical elements of producing 360-degree videos to create an immersive, research-based training package. To begin with, I'd just like to provide a little bit of background. I was part of a research team that over 2 years explored how child protection social workers begin, develop and sustain, or not, long-term relationships with children and families. We used a technique called ethnographic research, and what we did was we observed social workers at their desks, in offices, supervision in cars, working with families in their homes, in meetings and so on. We've produced a number of articles based on this research, and they're available on the link in the comment section below. As a team, we wanted our research to have an impact and change practices so that social workers and the families that they worked with had better positive outcomes. One of the ideas I suggested to the research team was, hey, why don't we create immersive 360-degree videos? That way, what we can do is we can recreate scenes from the research, allow people to put the headsets on and actually feel like as if they were there as part of the research project, and they could look at those elements that lead to good or not as good practice in terms of developing relationships with families and children who are part of the child protection process. The idea was to allow frontline practitioners and students, or indeed anybody interested in this field, to basically feel immersed in the training. And it was a different way of getting the research message across. One basically that came off the page and allowed people to virtually follow us in the research field. So over 2 years, I worked with the local Children's Trust and we created a 7-module based training package based on our research. I'll explain in future videos in much more detail the process that we went through to create this package. But in this video, what I'd like to do is just give you a little bit of a sense of what the trainees felt after they experienced using the package. The training package is called Research Informed Virtual Relationship Based Practice, or RIVER for short. To explain the training approach, I'm going to use the feedback from some of the students and the practitioners who have experienced the training. I wanted to give trainees the best seat in the house to observe what it's like to be a child protection social worker, carrying out their challenging role, and how they can build effective relationships that can lead to positive changes. To do this, our research showed that a range of issues such as professionalism, tone of voice, body language, etc., all played a part in determining whether families experienced good or bad relationships with their social workers. The advantages of using 360-degree headsets was that the trainees and the students felt as though they were there on the visit with the social worker. This allowed them to feel the emotions of what it's like to be on the visit, get a sense of the impact that body language can have on the role, have the ability to be conveyed into a setting where they can observe things that can impact on subtle nuances such as power balances and body language.
I think being one of the more experienced practitioners, it's been really useful to be part of the relationship-based practice project and the RIVER project in particular. And seeing the outcome of it today as we put on the headsets, I felt really immersed in the whole experience, and it felt very, very real.
You're immersed in the experience, so your senses are kind of brought to life as well.
And generates feelings and emotions as though you were on that visit or you were in that situation yourself.
When we was going with the social worker to first visit the family, and John, the father, was standing by the door, you got the sense of how it would feel to be in that sort of environment.
Because of the VR sets, it was quite realistic, and you were able to kind of tilt your head and look at the expressions of all the different people involved in that scene, particularly when there was different like power imbalances based on levels. So you had to like, in one case you had to like look up, and obviously that kind of symbolised the power imbalance that was kind of there if it was like reality.
I often find reading journal articles quite difficult, and I find myself rereading the article maybe four or five times before it's embedded. I think the benefits of the VR is that I'm there, I can listen to it, I can take my own notes in a format that is accessible to me, and I retain verbal information a lot more quickly and process it differently to how I read information. So for me personally, I would find this extremely accessible.
And it is fun. It's quite immersive. It's new technology that's like new in this century as well, so it has kind of a fun element to it as well.
We also wanted to create an environment in which the trainees and students could learn through observing a child protection social worker in a safe way, but at the same time feel as though they were actually there with them on the visit.
This method of research and how it can influence practice, it's a more immersive experience. I think it enables the trainee to see the options in a protective environment.
Yeah, I would definitely recommend this training to other students. Just because you get kind of a first-hand experience of the role of a statutory social worker, you get within the kind of comforts of like a classroom, so you can ask questions. And as a student, we haven't been out there, we haven't like seen it firsthand, so it definitely gives you kind of, yeah, that experience to build upon when you do go into practice.
Throughout the course, I've wanted to see sort of things that could be said or how situations could be handled. And I feel like using the VR headset, you were able to sort of observe a social worker in practice.
We didn't just use the films on their own, but we created a learning design that was carefully crafted so that trainers and educators could just pick up with it and run and deliver their own training. We also used a method where we replicated the same scene twice to subtly illustrate effective and less effective practice based on the findings of our research. We call these enabler and barrier scenes, and they've worked quite well. Rather than being a passive learning experience, we used the videos as triggers for discussion with more experienced workers.
I felt like I paid attention a little bit more because it wasn't just like a PowerPoint slide. And then we did have social workers come in as well, so we were able to ask questions and build upon the knowledge that we had learned in the river training to kind of like, yeah, advance our knowledge of the situation.
Some of the videos were so similar in the way they came across, but just the tone of voice that the social worker used, or the way they sat, so the way they faced, just those really little things really came across because you felt fully immersed in the videos.
Really good to kind of get an idea about the contrast in practice and how we can be enabling, or we can create barriers. Those barriers might be personal or professional experiences. Yeah, it gives a really good example of how we can visualise the differences and put them into practice.
I liked how when we sort of had the discussions on the table, we were able to compare experiences of practice as well.
So, were we able to get our research messages across? Initial findings from our evaluation suggest that we were successful, particularly in helping trainees and students understand through this immersive method why it's important to build good relationships. We were also successful in helping them understand the steps that they need to take to achieve effective relationship-based practices.
I do feel like using VR headsets is a good way of relaying research messages. I feel that the research that had taken place did come across during the videos, and we was able to discuss it after. So some of the examples that we saw on the headsets was then explained in further depth from social workers that were in the room with us.
It's caused me to rethink established patterns and ways of interacting with families, and how crucial and fundamental the relationship with our families is compared to anything else.
I think it will give me the confidence more so to support others, to implement relationship-based practice.
So what I've learned from the training about how to deal with hostile relationships and develop good relationships is just communication, planning and prepping, And I've taken away that just building any type of relationship is better than no relationship at all. Even if that seems like particularly small, that's something that you can build upon in the future. And just remaining like open and honest, being kind of transparent with the situation, it means that although people might not be happy with what's happening, as long as they know what's going on, and they don't feel like they're kind of like, you know, out of the situation. So it kind of taught me different ways to deal with like hostility, and how actually, if you do continue to develop those relationships, it can actually have a really positive outcome.
I think using this technique, it was a good way to see how a multi-agency approach can be used, how relationships can be built with families, how the use of language can be used. So using a service user's own words, using the child's voice in the process, recognising the strengths of the family as well, I think really came through throughout, especially in the relational video. So the enabler videos really showed how communication can be utilised, how just making a phone call before a visit can help comfort a family and not just turning up.
In future videos, I'll go into much more detail about how you yourself can actually create this type of training package. For anyone interested in delivering this training, we've created a Training the Trainer guide that will help you deliver this important training. If you're interested, then please do email me. My email details are below. I really hope you found this video interesting, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye.